No, for boys it's bar mitzvah and for girls it's bat mitzvah. For a group of people of mixed sexes, my synagogue uses b'nai mitzvah, which is masculine plural. There's no gender-neutral pronoun in Hebrew, just he, she, his, her, they and their masculine and they and their feminine. Despite how they may sound to some ears, grammatically gendered languages do not indicate gender identity, they indicate grammatical gender and, when referring to living things, biological sex, unless a person or group tells us otherwise. When speaking of a person whose biological sex is not known, like a fetus, one would use the masculine singular. When referring to a group of people of mixed sexes, one would use masculine plural. If the group were known to be all females, use the feminine plural. If there is one male or one gender-neutral person, use the masculine plural, unless that person has okayed the use of the feminine. It requires that the speaker actually talk to the group to ask them which pronouns they prefer. Talking to people. Asking questions. Accepting their answers and implementing them. Apparently, it is a lost art. And a hell of a lot more difficult than I think it is. But, hey, I've had to ask people about their sexual preferences and activities for my nosy nursing instructors. I can ask just about anything of just about anyone. I know that in the US and Canada, the term b'nai mitzvah is being used as gender neutral, however it's not. It's grammatically masculine plural. I'm not sure why people think it's gender neutral. Possibly because it can be translated as children of commandment, as well as sons of commandment. It is true that masculine nouns in Hebrew can be used as gender-neutral nouns. But then that just makes me wonder why they need to make it plural, since bar mitzvah could also be interpreted as child of commandment. No, for my bar mitzvah, I just called it a bar mitzvah. In most gendered languages, masculine is considered default, neutral, so it makes sense to me.